I can see the criticism in it.
Definitely think there's going to be a lot of annoyance factor going on in the next few days.
Putt-putt golf, like.
It's really like playing an open championship in the United States.
From gravel mine to major championship venue in just 8 years.
You can use your imagination a lot here.
This US Open has its fair share of quirky eccentricities that might just leave some players a little sleepless in Seattle this week.
We've had two different winds. You know, one's come out of the southwest, one of the northwest, and plays dramatically different.
Take the very first hole, for example, which, like the 18th, can play as either a par 5 on one day or as a par 4 the next.
It gets tricky. You're changing pars of the holes on, you know, different days.
The par 3 ninth hole actually has two different sets of tees, one of them dramatically 100 feet downhill to a green protected by bunkers. Or it can play slightly uphill from a completely different angle to the same green, but over those same menacing bunkers.
Unlike any links golf that we play, we don't have elevation changes like this.
I think it's one of the cooler holes that we'll play all year.
The 12th may be an uphill drivable par 4, but beware. This is the tightest fairway in tournament history at just 13 yards wide. At the very next hole, though, we're talking the widest fairway in US Open history at around 115 yards.
My personal favorite, though, has to be this idyllic spot right behind the 15th green. You know, this is the first US Open to have only one tree on it. And it's a tree that does also have an interesting tale of survival, too, having been vandalized back in 2008 when someone cruelly decided to plow an axe into it.
By the way, did we mention the runaway freight train a hole later at 16?
They definitely don't mind honking their, you know, horn or whatever you call it on a train. I have no idea.
Question is, whose title charge might it derail?
I'm going to try not to hit them, but if we can stay away from that, that'd be great.
In short, the players will have to adapt to the formidable challenge here, and quickly.
I think we're going to see some higher numbers here.
I think it might be slower rounds of golf given the size of the greens and the difficulty of the course. So at least we have some nice views as well.
Raising their game to new heights like never before.